Hello and welcome to News Pulse. I'm Esther. The Union Cabinet on December 15 cleared the proposal to raise the legal age of marriage for women from 18 to 21 years. This move would bring the legal age of marriage for women at par with men, which is 21 years. The move now will require a law to be tabled in Parliament to amend personal laws governing age of marriage, such as the prohibition of child marriage. Currently, for Hindus, Sikhs, Jains and Buddhists, the Hindu Marriage Act sets 18 years as the minimum age of the bride and 21 years for the groom. In Islam, the personal laws lay down that the marriage of a minor who has attained puberty is considered to be of marriageable age. A 2017 UN report also said that as many as 27% of Indian girls are married before they turned 18. To discuss further on the pros and cons of this decision by the cabinet, we have my colleague Al. Al, hi.
Hi, Esther.
Yeah, Al, could you tell us, like, what is the difference between getting married at 18 and 21? Even though at 18 you're already an adult and most crucial decisions are made at that age as well.
Yeah, the question made me smile because I'm thinking, hey, I'm going to get married too. Anyway, yeah, the central government, they have passed a proposal, and for now it has yet to be a bill. Now it has yet to be a full legislation. However, to your question, there is no rationale behind coming up with a new legislation that would regulate the age of persons marrying or not marrying before 18 or not. The real intent, I believe, here is that they are actually putting up, they are changing the age of the person so that it will run for the Child Marriage Prohibition Act. So what the government is doing is that they are trying to increase the age of, the age for a woman to get married to 21 so that they will be able to go for higher careers, for instance. And they also want to decrease infant mortality rate and maternity mortality rate too. And besides, I think what they are trying to do is, like, they also want to have the woman to enjoy full nutritional maturity before they take important decisions like getting married.
Okay. Al, also, this would also probably mean delaying the rights of a woman from 18 to 21, or her personal views and matters of importance to her would also really mean a little delay to her rights. Won't you say that?
That is something I cannot really specifically answer, but I think so far as what the government is telling us is that the proposal has been floated based on a number of health factors, which I pointed out just a bit earlier, and also to enable them to attain physiological and psychological maturity before they actually take important decisions like marriages and even family planning.
Okay, well, India's marginalized girls are also fighting child marriage, you know, and will this also help in that, this decision to,
yeah.
I mean, not only that, and let's talk about also, you know, the pandemic. It has pushed people to even, you know, be below the poverty line. We have, India is full of that, with the level is very high, and then, but does this help that? Does this solve any problem in that?
There are political observers who are actually saying that this new proposal might not really be helping the cause of people who marry before they are 18. In 2020, when the pandemic started, there was a 50% increase of child marriages in India.
Right.
And that's a huge, huge number. So it's not legislation per se, because the factors, the reasons why children get married are not necessarily political. They are sociocultural. For example, there is a question of families who think, like, not marrying their daughters off is a dishonor to their family. And there are people who are poor, and because they are poor, they cannot afford the family. What they do is they marry off their daughters, for example. And then there are people who cannot afford, who don't have access to school. So which means if you don't have access to schools, you are at home most of the time. And which means if you have to just stay there, you know, someone will have to say eventually, oh, I think you better start working, because there are no schools and you don't have any skills. What you can do is go to the fields and start working. So there are a lot of factors here. And legislation itself will not help. what I believe will help is that we can set up, we can give more more access to the girls to have quality education, for example,
right.
or set up training centers. Mm. So it's not about delay or furthering the age of marriage. I think it's all about first examining their social cultural foundations,
right.
examine their economic lives, mm-hmm. and then based on it, we can make adjustments to the to the marriageable age.
Okay, right. Thank you, Al. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Esther. Thank you.